turn our attention to markets not only in the United States, because they're rising all over, particularly in places like Canada, which is resource rich. The Toronto Stock Exchange Composite Index, it's up more than 17% if you take a look at the last 52 weeks. And my next guest expects the surge to continue. Robert Haber is the chief executive of Haber Trilix Advisors, managing more than almost $2 billion. He is also the author of the book Go Canada, The Coming Boom in the Toronto Stock Market and How to Profit from It. And also, it's a big footnote, he's an part owner of the Boston Celtics. Bob Haber, good to have you with us on Bloomberg. Let's start with talking about Canada, right? Resource rich, politically stable, close to the United States. What's not to love, right?
Right. Thank you. Thank you, Pimm, for talking about all the great things about Canada. About 50% of the Canadian market is energy and materials. The currency is very strong. Politics are stable. Profit outlook is great. And it's underappreciated here in the States and in Europe as well. It's underappreciated.
So you see there are going to be a lot more investors wanting to get into the Canadian markets. I mean, big investors from China have already made investments in things like the Athabasca oil sands in Western Canada. Do you see more of that happening?
Yeah, absolutely. So we know there's a desire to get into energy equities around the world, and there's a desire to get into gold mining equities. When you look at where those stocks are listed and where they operate, roughly half are in the Canadian market. So in my view, those are some of the growth industries in the next 5 to 10 years. And you've got to consider Canada, shop in Canada for those equities.
Now, when you take a look at those kinds of companies in Canada, you'd be naive to think that they're all the same, because every now and again, you'll hear about a very small company in Canada and they're penny stocks, right? I mean, you've got a lot of these sort of small operators that have got claims in certain areas that are trying to prove that they've got the resources. Is that an area where people ought to be investing money, or should they stick with the established names?
I think the blue chips at the moment are great. Mid caps, some of them are great with proved production. Take a look at Suncor, which is probably...
I was going to say Suncor, Cenovus, companies like that.
Right, the best known name. So over the next 10 years, I predict Suncor will more than double production of oil per share. And I think when we meet 10 years from now on the show, that will be an amazing feat that very few, if any, larger oil companies have replicated. And it's not that expensive.
Will that intervening period mean go by without someone coming in and making a play to acquire Suncor?
I think a lot of the sovereign wealth funds, if they could, would buy all of Canada. But after the Potash episode, and certainly for a strategic asset like Suncor, that's off the table now.
One of the things that's happened, though, in Canada is this move away from income trusts, right? I mean, there was a whole structure set up where a lot of the dividend, a lot of the cash was passed to investors, and it was almost like a REIT structure in the United States. That change has been made into law. What has that affected? How has that affected investors?
Well, it is changed, and it's all done with pretty much. The REITs remain REITs, so they still have the same properties. The oil companies kept high dividends, generally speaking, and so did some of the other companies. And like everywhere else in the world, there's a search for yield. And so those companies are still doing well because instead of double-digit yields, they still have certainly high yields.
Bob Haber, agriculture stocks. You mentioned Potash, Saskatchewan. This was a company going to be taken over, or there was a bid to take it over by BHP Billiton. Got rejected. What's the future for something like Potash?
Well, first of all, that's one of the first companies that the Canadian government said, no, we're not going to allow it. There's been a string of real gems that have been taken over, and it's now a bit of a sore spot in Canada. I think the outlook is great for Potash, and I'm an owner of it, and I think it's a resource without which the world might starve, literally. It's so powerful in its application around the world, and so outlook is bright.
All right, so that's agricultural resources. Tell me about other resources. You've been following Teck Resources as well as Hud Bay.
Yeah, Teck is a company that came, it's the Lazarus in Canada. It was literally on death's doorstep in 08, having taken on a big merger and a lot of debt at the wrong time. But that merger ends up being a pretty good one now because it gives them a huge position in metallurgical coal. And now, with the unfortunate need to rebuild a lot of the Japanese infrastructure, plus what's going on continuously in China and India, met coal is on the rise. And Teck also gives you kind of a second hit in copper, and copper will be another beneficiary of what's going on.
All right, so you got Teck Resources. Tell me about HUD Bay.
Yeah, HUD Bay Minerals, another double play, so to speak. They've got some copper, and they've got some gold, and it's also going to be one of the fastest growing metals companies. And the management there has done this before. They know how to grow the mines, and it's a company that probably won't be there next time we talk in a few years.
All right, so Teck Resources, HUD Bay, as well as Potash. Talking about play, though, I got to ask you, you're a part owner of the Boston Celtics.
Yes.
How did you end up, I mean, how come you're not buying a hockey team if you're interested in Canada? Aren't you supposed to be, like, on the ice, not on the boards?
Well, I grew up in the Bronx, so there wasn't a heck of a lot other than basketball. It's my sport. And when the opportunity came along, I said, raised my hand and said, absolutely, I'm in.
All right. So you're going to the game tonight.
I am, yes.
Celtics, make sure you don't tell too many people.
I know. I keep quiet at all those
You can
games.
Tell me from the Bronx, but that's about
that's
it.
That's about it, yeah.
All right. Bob Haber, thank you very much from Haber Trilix, giving us some insight into investing in Canada. Appreciate
thank
it.
You.